Here is Young underneath. Kale up top. And now Evans guards McMorrow, and he turns, spins, and misses. Rainmen still up 2-0 here in the early going.
Halifax foul number 28, Kevin Young. That'll be his first. That'll be the team's second. Now into the ball game for the Island Storm. Number 6, Mike Martin.
All right, folks, I think we're up and going here in Charlottetown at Eastling Center. I am Brett Poirier on the call here. What an exciting game this is. So much on the line. The Atlantic Division Championship here in Charlottetown. The Halifax Rainmen Island Storm battling this one out. These two teams have gone head-to-head all year, with the Storm winning the battle 4-3 as far as the season series go. And despite the rumors, there is no difference in the points with who will actually win the season series in this, because it's purely the winner that will take the Atlantic Division title.
33, Liam McMurrow. That'll be his first. That'll be the team's third. No basket. Your SL's missing the S. Your plane's missing a chef. The common theme, see they both got wings. If you fly, do it to death. It's only one God and it's only one crown. So it's only one king that can stand on this mound.
Kevin Young.
All right, we are patched up and ready to go here. Here's Famitini up top now. Zaglinski in the corner. Also a miss that time for Okori. He couldn't get the bucket that time, but he has really been playing well of late. Since Brandon Robinson went out with injury a few games ago, he has been that go-to guy for the Storm. Endo with the putback, he scores. Now the Storm are down 6-0. And a foul is called. It will be Rainmen basketball now.
Storm foul, number 50, Nick Evans. That will be his first. That will be the team's first.
And what does this game mean here? Well, the Atlantic Division title, which comes down to this game. Both of these teams stand at 19-12 on the season. So the winner will be 20-12, while the loser falls to 19-13. Here's Okori up top. Sticks it.
Big Okori! Our three! Woo!
Now in low, McMorrow loses the handle. Coach Salerno furious with the call. Still talking with the officials right now. And folks, you can find me on Twitter at Brett Power at Brett NBA. Really appreciate everyone who tunes into these games, we know there is a lot of fans, including the great Janice Mitchell, who always tunes into these games. I know she is watching right now. She was very concerned about this not making it to air, but we're here for you, Janice, and all of those great fans in Nova Scotia. Here's KO on the spin. That one floats out. The storm bench is fired up right now. All right, so let's take a look at the starting lineups here for the Storm. Nick O'Corey, Mike Martin, Sammy Zaglinski, Ulu Famitini, and Nick Evans. And it is O'Corey who scores that one. For the Rainmen on the court, Saya Endo along with Joey Haywood in the backcourt. Chris Kale is out there along with Clifford Klinkscales and Liam McMorrow. Also on the court, Kevin Young. I guess I just named off six players. Right now, Klinkscales is not in the ball game. Was. Step back. And Endo gets the board. Rainmen still up 9-5 in the early going here. Haywood up top. And he steps back. The Saint of X product. No good that time. Mike Martin now working on Kale. He's got 10 on the shot clock. Kale pokes it away, and now Kevin Young running back. He comes and tries to dunk it. He's going to lay it in instead. Nice job by Young, able to transition in the air. Really good body control. We know how explosive he is, and he's got an excellent set of hops. O'Corey is trapped. He calls for Evans to get to him, and Mike Martin up top for three. A little strong, but on the weak side, they're going to say a foul is called against Nick Evans. He doesn't like that call, and I don't think Coach Salerno also approves. They're going to say that Evans pushed off. And for Evans, that's his second foul, so Mike Williams will check into this ball game. Already a disadvantage because this Halifax team, one of the biggest teams in this league for strength and height. Of course, they have Young, McMorrow, Spikes, Daly. They're a big, big team, and for the Storm, they play a much smaller style of basketball.
Joey Haywood.
So right now for the Storm, they have to find a way to match up against McMorrow, who is about 7 inches taller than Mike Williams. That will be a challenge. O'Corey to Birdsong. Now Birdsong goes in. That one just rolls around and out, and Birdsong with the putback, he scores it.
Birdsong.
Endo guarded by Zaglinski. He was almost double teamed. Zaglinski matches up against him again. McMorrow sets a back screen, and Endo gets right in there for the two. Saya Endo has really been coming to his own here at Eastlink Center. The first two games he played, he was very ineffective, couldn't get too much done from an offensive standpoint, but now he's really come together, getting points, and he's actually hitting the three-pointer, something that everyone knows he can do so well. We will have a timeout here from Charlottetown.
All access pass that includes print, edition, and the website. The Guardian. Alrighty, Eastlink Center, it's time now for the Sherwood BMR foul shooting contest. Joining me on the court right now, we have Jessica Doyle and Charlene Wardrop. Make a little noise for our contestants. Alright, we're going to see who can drop the most foul shots in 24 seconds, alright? And you guys have to cheer really, really, really loud every time they sink one, alright? So here we go, 24 seconds on clock. Ladies, let's go. All right, so far, so not great. For snowshoes, we want to make sure you ladies can get to all of the Storm games, weather permitting. Here you go. I don't know who wins in that game. We'll figure something out for you. Make some noise for your Island Storm, Eastlink Center! Ladies and gentlemen, we want to give a shout out here tonight to members of the Charlottetown Royalty Rotary Club. They are out tonight en masse supporting the storm. It's their monthly outing, and we're glad to have them here. Shout out to the Charlottetown Royalty Rotary Club.
Back here from Charlottetown, the Island Storm have been struggling of late. They've lost four in a row, and meanwhile, the Halifax Rainmen, are red hot. They've won nine straight. So for the Storm, who have not been victorious against this team in quite some time, they really have a huge challenge tonight, and they are without their leading scorer, Brandon Robinson, once again. Right now, he is attending the funeral of his great-grandfather, who unfortunately passed away last week. He is down with family for the week. So our thoughts are, of course, with Robinson during this tough time. But now for the Storm, you know how much he wants to be here. He was up on the show a few weeks ago, and he was just expressing how much he would do anything to be on the court in these final games of the regular season. Now at the line for Halifax, it is McMorrow, 7'2", 275 pounds, went to Tennessee Tech from Toronto, Ontario, sticks them.
Into the ball game for Halifax, number five, four.
He's already become a number one enemy here in Charlottetown. The fans do not like McMorrow and Kevin Young. I don't know why they're after those two guys. I think it's McMorrow for the height purely. They think he's bullying the other players on the court. It might be true. 7'2" is pretty tough to stop. And then Young is so explosive. Very aggressive player, and the fans definitely want him to be less of a factor here tonight. And I know that's the style for Coach Salerno, is to eliminate the stars on the other team. And for Kevin Young, Halifax's leading scorer, he'll have to do just that. Forrest Fisher in the game. That one off the mark. And now Famutini kicks it out. Okori has it. He was thinking about an entry pass to Williams, but Famutini will take three. There he goes. Now a six-point ball game here, 16-10 in favor of the visitors. Endo breaks free from Zaglinski, and there he sticks it. He's having a hot start to this game. He's got six. A turnover that time. Kale's coming up court. Foul and one.
That's the count for Chris Kale.
Chris Kale, the former Storm player from Burlington, Vermont. He was originally selected by the Storm in the NBL in that 2011 inaugural draft. He went on to become a two-time NBL All-Star, and he played with the Storm during their first two seasons in the league.
And number 22, Rashad Wack.
He suffered an Achilles tendon injury, but he was a former slam dunk champion. One of the elite dunkers this league has seen. And we exceptionally get to see that in his earlier days here in Summerside when he was even a bit younger of a player. He was so explosive. Right now we don't see as much. He's really become a shooter more so than an explosive player, but he can do both very well still. The handoff this time to Wack. 3:40 left here in the first. Wack goes in the corner. Here is Rush. There we go.
Billy! For three.
And the Storm are living and dying right now by the three ball. They're still down 21-13. A traveling call will be ticketed. That time, it looks like it will go against Clink Scales. So too many steps for him. Clink Scales is one of those players with an incredible resume. Played some great basketball growing up. He always likes to get outside and play basketball when he's home, too. We'll talk a little bit more about that in a while. Hopefully he'll get to the free throw line, so I have a minute to chat about him. And a foul on the three. Not what you want if you're Halifax. And now Rashad Wack will get two shots at the pardon me, three shots at the free throw line because he was just outside of the three-point circle.
That'll be the game four for John Wack at the line. He'll shoot three for the Storm.
And there's Wack, hits his first. He's about as consistent as you would want at the free throw line. And for the Storm, they don't mind sending him there because he can really perform when he's needed to. For a rookie, too. Definitely the rookie of the year leading candidate to date for this Storm team. But right now, at the free throw line, he is going to take his third shot. And he hits all three. Great crowd here at Eastlink Center tonight. About 2,000 inside to cheer on their Storm in the last regular season game. And the officials are going to say a foul right now, and it looks like they're pointing at Birdsong. So a lot of fouls early on in this one. This would be the 11th team foul. And we're only, I guess right now, only 9 minutes into this ball game here. So for both of these teams who have been chippy in the past, this doesn't look like it will be any exception here. And if you're just tuning in, Nick Evans is on the bench right now with two early fouls. He got those within the first 3 minutes of this ballgame.
Back into the ballgame for the Storm, number six, Mike Martin. Also into the ballgame for Halifax, number 42, Nigel Spikes.
So now Nigel Spikes checks in for Halifax. Mike Martin steps back. That one hits front iron. It will be short. Storm still down here. 23-16, 2:30 left in the first quarter. I'm Brett Poirier on the call. Find me on Twitter at Brett Poe or at Brett NBA. Clink Scales gets one up and scores it. Zaglinski getting a lot of early minutes in this one. Taking over that role as, oh my goodness, what a shot by Martin. He's looking for a foul too. Clink Scales up top, Wack guards him, 9 on the shot clock. Clink Scales was stuck, he rolls it in again. He's looking for a foul. Everyone's looking for fouls here. I think there's been enough called. 11 already have been called. Zaglinski's in trouble. Jump ball coming up between Watson and Zaglinski on the floor. So the possession arrow goes to the Storm. Here's Williams trying to post up. He's going to kick it out instead. Rush goes in, nearly turns it over, gets it back, and Williams spots up. Mid-range jumper is good. Williams so good in that 17-foot range, about as consistent as you can get for a big man in this league. In trouble, Clink Scales looks to get it away. He gets it to Fisher up top. 6 on the shot clock. A lot of dribbling and passing outside the perimeter. Halifax has to shoot a 3. It doesn't matter. They hit it. And Clink Scales stares down the Storm bench. A 10-point lead for Halifax. The Storm, a little sluggish to come out, but you have to give credit to Halifax. They have played really well in the early going here. Mike Martin, step back. Second chance for the Storm. That was saved by Williams. Now Martin, he's got 3 Rainmen on him. Zaglinski inside, Martin in trouble. 10 on the clock, Williams off the mark. And a foul called. The Halifax bench is fired up once again. This team has came out of nowhere this season. And many say in Halifax, the team to beat right now in the NBL. And they're showing the Storm why that could be true. Right now, up 10 points in the early going here. And they will go to the line for 2.
control the storm.
Tyrone Watson, 6'5", 230-pound guard out of Hamilton, Ontario. He went to New Mexico State, and he was also in three March Madness tournaments during his tenure at the university.
The ball game for Halifax, number 9, Freddie Apia.
Now Apia checks into the game. Halifax not afraid to use their bench in this game. So the shot clock should be turned off here. It looks like there's a little more time on the shot clock. 10 seconds on the game clock. And Halifax forcing the storm to turn it over once again.
Into the ball game for Halifax. Number 5, Forrest Fisher.
So now Fisher checks back into this game, and Halifax has 6.6 seconds to get their shot up. So Clint Scales in the backcourt now with 4 seconds. He's going to attack to the basket. And that one is going to count.
For number 22,
the Rainmen up 34-20 in the early going. The Storm have a lot of work to do. We'll be right back
after
here on Universal Media.
Rainmen 34, your Island Storm 20. Ladies and gentlemen, the Island Storm wish to thank our meal sponsors for their support this season. They include Boston Pizza, Casabia, Eastside Mario's, Izzy Sports Bar, Outriders Cookhouse, and Sam's Family Restaurant. All right, Eastling Center, start with the Fox Meadow Putting Challenge here. Joined on board, I have Lee and Kelly Dawson. Lee is going to go first, trying to get it as close as he can to the pylon. Make a little noise. That was going to wind up well left and short. All right. Kelly, it's all on you. You got this. You got this. Oh my God, you don't. Look at that. It hit a hazard on the way by. Kelly, you're the winner. Congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, our mascot, Stormy McCloud, is brought to you by Burgoyne Construction. Ladies and gentlemen, if you and your family would like to sit in an on-alcohol section during storm games, just check out our Eastlink Family Fun Zone. It is in section number 21. And don't forget to get your favorite Storm player's autograph after the game in the lobby at Eastlink Center here at our Storm Autograph Table. All right, time for the second quarter, and it's brought to you by Capital Honda and the 2015 Honda Civic. It's Canada's best-selling car, 17 years running. The 2015 Honda Civic from Capital Honda keeps wowing generations of drivers with Honda's legendary fun to drive performance, fuel efficiency. That's fuel efficiency and slam dunk styling. It starts from only $42 weekly from Capital Honda.
The Island Storm have a lot of ground to make up early here. They are down 34-20 at the start of the second. I am Brett Poirier on the call from beautiful Charlottetown, Prince Edward Island. But it isn't too beautiful if you're the Storm right now, because they are down in a hole, and a hole is something that has been a pattern for this team in the last 4 games. They've lost all 4 of those games. And for Coach Salerno's team, they have missed Brandon Robinson dearly, but it goes deeper than that. You just cannot rely on one player to get you your W's. The Storm haven't won since he left the lineup, but it still is much more than that. You just have to find a way to beat bigger, more physical teams. And right now the Storm have been completely shocked, but more so than shocked, they just haven't had any type of an answer for this Halifax team ever since they added up and bolstered their front court depth. And right now they have really experimented with lineups. Has the Storm Alex DeRosh in this game. Rush getting lots of extra minutes right now. They're trying to go big if possible. We see Nick Evans back into the ball game, but so far nothing has worked for the Storm.
Defense!
on the court for the Rainmen. Klinkscales, Watson out there along with Daly, Fisher. And that's a foul called on that play. Just going to see what the final call is.
Storm foul number six.
It's going to go against Martin.
That'll be the team's first. On the foul line for Halifax, to shoot two, number 42, Nigel Spikes.
So Nigel Spikes steps to the line. And for the Storm, they have Evans, Darosh, Rush, Martin, and Okori on the court. So not a lot of scoring either. You have Nick Okori, your primary scorer, who averages about 15 a game. And then Nick Evans, who's around that 12-13 mark, and he has really stepped up his game this year offensively. But still, the Storm have always tried to keep two or three primary perimeter scorers on. So you normally have Okori or Robinson, even a Zaglinski or a Williams on, but right now they just have their one go-to guy. Mike Martin can put up points in a hurry too, but he's not your Brendan Robinson Okori go-to guy offensively. So without Robinson, of course, everything is just shuffled up a little bit extra. And the putback dunk by Daly right over Evans. The Halifax bench up once again. They're really supporting their ball team right now. Such a great group of guys on this Halifax club. Darosh, little floater inside, no good. Rush now up top to Okori. Finds Martin, spinning, turning, and he's going to float one up. That's a miss. Right now the Storm look nervous. They're getting inside. They're throwing up quick shots. When they're outside, they're hesitant to take those shots. So we'll see if this second quarter changes anything. But right now there's still over 10 minutes to play. And this by no means is too big of a hole for them to get out of, even by halftime. Now here's Evans. This is a matchup they should be taking advantage of. And he misses too. The Storm just cold offensively from the field. Their percentage is down, shooting 35%. Clint Scales inbounds to Watson. 17 on the clock for Halifax. Watson goes right inside. No defense by the Storm on that one. And here's Rush now. Rush turns it over. Klingstales guarded by Evans. Will he take advantage of that matchup? No, it's going to be dumped inside, and the slam. We will have a timeout called by the Storm. The Millrats, pardon me, the Rainmen. Oh, my goodness. I already have these first-round playoff matchups in my head. The Rainmen will take a 19-point lead. We'll be right back here in Charlottetown.
The all-new Honda Fit is anything but classic. With second-row magic seats, the 2015 Honda Fit possesses the versatility to handle anything your friends can throw at it. Now, starting from only $39 weekly, that's the 2015 Honda Fit from Capital Honda.
All right, it's time for one of my personal favorites here, the Storm uniform game. I have Cassie McGilvery and Nalia Lavoie here with me tonight, okay? They're going to put on some Storm uniforms, go down for a layup. First person to do it is going to get a foam finger, all right? Are you guys ready? Eastlink Center, are you ready? On your marks, get set, go! Should have heard the trash talking before we come out here. These girls both want to win. Oh, that was an interesting maneuver, doing the sneakers at the same time as the jersey. Nice. All right, here we go. Pull up your pants. You should pull up your pants. Oh, we got our winner down here. Congratulations. Eastlink Center, keep it going. Rear Island Storm.
back here in Charlottetown. Things are not looking good for the Storm right now. Down by 19, but so much time to go. The Storm just have to start playing more defensive-minded basketball right now. It's been all easy going for the Rainmen in this one. And Okori with another turnover, and turnovers have been an issue. That's the Storm's ninth already. A turnover that time for Halifax. And the Storm are probably happy to see that. That's only their seventh. Now an offensive foul by the Storm. Things are just not going the Orange and Blues away right now. So Wack checks back into this game. Okori will come out. And for Okori, that's his third personal foul. So he might be on the bench the rest of this quarter. Kling scales up top. Wack trying to cover him. He's caught in a screen. And now they get the Kling scales. A lot of reach and hands, but get that garbage out of here, Mike Martin says. And now DeRoche running down court. Gets it to Zaglinski, 4-3, in and out. McMorrow goes in easy, and he scores another two. Now the Halifax Rainmen up by 21. That time a foul called against Watson as DeRoche trying to penetrate through to the basket.
Halifax foul number 8, Tyrone Watson. That will be his first. That will be the team's second.
Checking a reminder, folks, this Halifax team has won 9 straight ball games. They are so deadly right now. 2015 has been the year of the Rainmen in the NBL, no doubt about it. And for Coach Pep Claros, he's got his team running on all cylinders.
Halifax foul, number 8, Tyrone Watson. That'll be his second. That'll be the team's third.
The Storm's last 3 losses came here at Eastlink Center. They lost to London the day of Al Stewart's return, and then they lost to St. John prior to that. And the first loss here at Eastlink Center in this streak came against this Halifax Rainmen team. Birdsong was fouled on the court.
And the Halifax foul number 3, Zaya Ando. That'll be his second. That'll be the team's fourth. Chris Kale checks back in for Halifax.
Zaglinski with the turnover. Evans gets lucky that time. That one just fell right into his arms, and he scores. Back to a 19-point deficit. Kevin Young back into the ball game. A lot of contact there. Birdsong is down on the ground right now. Looks like he got a shoulder to the head. He'll get back up, and now Young. Fisher in the corner, he's going to jack up a 3, a little strong, and Evans tracks down that board. Zaglinski kicks it up top, now Wack has it. Birdsong feeds Evans. Evans spins, shoots, a lot of contact on that play. He wanted a foul, no call there. And Wack picks off that alley-oop attempt, and now the officials say, travel.
Back into the ball game.
Here's Zaglinski now. Birdsong goes in, and now an offensive foul has been called. Another tough call for the Storm. The turnovers just keep piling and piling up.
Storm foul number 24, Lewis Birdsong. That'll be his third. That'll be the team's third.
Da, 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 da. Whack on Endo. Just over 6 minutes and 40 seconds left here in the second. The Rainmen up big. A handoff underneath and rejected at the rim. And that was a hard foul. Nick Evans and Young getting involved, and now McMorrow. Nick Evans is furious right now. He almost got at McMorrow and Young. McMorrow approached Evans on that play. And that's the last thing the Storm need right now. Extracurriculars would be the worst idea for a team down by 19 points. That's not what you need, and especially a flagrant or technical foul just to give more easy points to Halifax would be absolutely deadly for this team. Haywood now. Evans on him. Now Zaglinski back to him. Haywood gets right inside. He's fouled too. So Joey Haywood, 6'1" guard out of Vancouver, British Columbia. He played for this Halifax Rainmen team from 2011 to 2013, but he left to pursue other opportunities. He played in Denmark, the top league in that country, where he averaged 25 points per game. So he has quite the pedigree. He is a scorer, plain and simple. Zaglinski turns it over. Young coming in with a slam.
Kevin Young.
And this is getting out of control quickly for the Island Storm. They are now down by 24 points. And another turnover. Haywood underneath. McMorrow slams it down. 50-24. The Storm have never played this poorly here on home court in a very long time. Since the Summerside days, that first season, I've never seen them play this bad. We'll see if they can get out of the slump. Here is Whack in the corner. They needed that one. It's only a two, though.
Rashawn Whack!
Haywood up top. Whack, really stagnant defense on him. A turnover that time. Whack falls down. And Halifax swarming the backcourt. That should be a foul on Famuccini. And a foul. And the crowd is furious here. That was an easy call against Famuccini. And the baseline official didn't make the call right now. And Coach Lerno is saying that's inexcusable. So that is official Jeff Smith on the baseline, who neglected to make that call. He might not have seen it, but I don't know how you couldn't have seen that one. That was a pretty easy call from up here. Clearly, Famuccini was grabbed. Zaglinski goes in. He gets the floater off the glass. Now a 22-point deficit. Endo, a lot of dribbling here. McMorrow can't handle it, and the Storm get it back. Williams calling for the post up. He's in trouble. Zaglinski gets right inside, and no call that time. McMorrow doing the ball handling right here. Gets it to Kale up top. A miss that time. Kevin Young all over the glass. Zaglinski underneath. He gets the layup.
Zaglinski and Rashawn Whack.
And the Storm now trying to play a Halifax Rainmen style. You can see they're starting to be really aggressive at the top. This game's starting to get really chippy here, but the fouls have not been called either way. The Storm probably just committed a foul there, too. And that should have been a foul, too, on Wack. These calls just aren't being made right now for either side. Very interesting. It's like the officials lost their whistles. And finally, a call is made. That time, it looks like it will go against Famutini. That was quite the sequence of 2 minutes there. Not one call was made.
Storm foul. Number five, Olo Famutini. That'll be his first. That'll be the team's sixth. Into the ball game for Halifax, number 12, Cliff Clinchscales. And number 22, Jermaine Daly.
So some substitutions being made right now. Daly will come in. Clinchscales will come in. Durosh checking back in for the Storm. Kale also out there, along with Haywood and McMorrow for Halifax. Williams, Rush, Famutini, and Zaglinski for the Storm. Here's Clinchscales. He's double-teamed, breaks free from that, and now McMorrow wide open underneath. Another defensive breakdown by the Storm. And to be totally fair for the Storm, McMorrow, a tough body. He's got 9 points right now, but they have to find a way to keep him outside. They don't have to worry about him scoring if he's outside of that perimeter.
Chris Kale.
Now Chris Kale scores back up to a 24-point advantage for Halifax. Mike Williams in the corner. There we go.
Mike Williams.
Crowd chanting defense here. 7 on the clock. Clinchscales sends it up top. Daly couldn't connect that time. Durosh pump fake. He gets inside. He attacks the much bigger McMorrow. He gets the end one. Pep Claros can't believe the call. And McMorrow was standing still, but it looks like he might have dipped his body a little bit over.
Halifax foul number 33, Liam McMorrow. That'll be his second. That'll be the team's sixth.
So we'll have a timeout here on the court. Storm down big from Charlottetown.
Second quarter is brought to you by Capital Honda and the newly redesigned 2015 Honda's CR-V. Expect to hear wow a lot when you're driving Motor Trend's 2015 SUV of the year. That's the 2015 Honda CR-V. Jam-packed with features and bold new styling. It starts at only $69 weekly. That's from Capital Honda. They're located at 40 Lower Malpec Road in Charlottetown. Want to wish happy birthday, an early happy birthday, a 27th happy birthday to Jacinta McLeod sitting up in a luxury box here today. All right, happy birthday, Jacinta McLeod.
All right, we're going to get some life in this building right now. Stormy, you got your side. I'm going to take my usual side. Your side always wins for some reason. I don't know why that is. All right, over on this side, you're going to cheer for me on the count of three. One, two, three. That was pretty good, Stormy. Let's see what your side has. One, two, three. I think you guys win again over here. How about everybody right now for your Storm, for these guys right now?
Alex Durosh looks to complete the three-point play. He shoots 82% at the line. And there he goes. So now the Storm back down by 19. Applying pressure is the Storm. A foul was called, though. And boos ring out here at Eastlink Center. Jeff Smith has been the unpopular official here in the building tonight. That's a few calls the fans have not agreed with. And now that call will go against Famutini, so that means free throws are coming up for Halifax. So the Storm in this ball game so far have committed 14 personal fouls. Halifax only 9. That one rims out for Clint Scales. Pretty consistent free throw shooter he is. From Queens, New York, DePaul University. This is a really cool fact. He actually played some basketball in the Rutgers Park finale where he broke, not actually broke, but he dropped ESPN's Jay Williams with a wicked crossover. That was a really cool video I got to watch earlier today. So definitely, if you're the Storm, you want to keep an eye out for that crossover from Clint Scales. DeRosh hands it in to Famutini. He gets right inside, hands it off to Rush. There we go. The Storm slowly chipping back in. They were down by 24 just a moment ago. Now down by 18. And if you're the Storm, you want to make this about 12 or 15 points going into halftime if you can do it. That will be Storm basketball.
Timeout, Halifax.
And Halifax now calls timeout. We'll be right back here on Universal Media.
Stop in and see Wilbur Bird, Peter McLean, Albert Kays, John Arsenault, Ben Jacker, Wade Stewart, and test drive any of the great vehicles available at Capital Honda. They're located on 40 Lower Malpec Road, Charlottetown. Visit their website, www.capitalhonda.com. Ladies and gentlemen, the Island Storm want to thank these sponsors for their support of Storm basketball this season: Atlantic Windows, Sherwood BMR, Capital Honda, CMCY, the Conley Group, Domino's Pizza, Eastlink Corporation, Fox Meadow, Go PEI, Hillside Motors, Kinlock Creek, and Quick Copy. Here's Stormy McLeod, brought to you by Burgoyne Construction.
Halifax will inbound the basketball under their net with 9 seconds on the shot clock, a minute 14 on the game clock. They are up a big, though, out of the Rainmen. 55-37 is the score. Famutini crashes the glass. There he goes. Famutini gets inside. He scores that one. Talk about hang time. That was a tough hoop for Famutini. Now the Storm are down 55-39, under a minute to play here in the half. Clink Scales, he was left wide open. He almost shot it, but he decided to pass instead. And that time, no call was made by the officials. Halifax wanted one for spikes. Williams with the pass inside. There we go, with the slam! Billy Rush gets this crowd excited.
From Mike Williams.
A little bit of life by this Storm team. Let's see if they can close the half strong. They really need to do that. Lockdown defense up top by DeRosh on Clink Scales. Now a switch. Spikes is left all alone. You have to get to him. And that one floated up. Offensive rebound. 2 seconds left. Rush is going to throw it up at the buzzer. Oh, that almost went down. right now the Storm are down 55-41, but they show a little sign of life right now. We'll be back here in the third.
Your Island Storm 41. This second quarter brought to you by Capital Honda. Ladies and gentlemen, the Island Storm want to thank the following sponsors for their support of Storm Basketball. They include Quick Coffee, Parker Realty, Party Perfect, Pepsi, Pre-Built Steel, Q93, Red Shores Racetrack and Casino, Spud 102 FM, Tim Hortons, the University of Prince Edward Island, Wendy's Restaurant, and Windsor Park. We want to thank these fine sponsors for their support of Storm Basketball, including our official trainers of the Storm, UPEI Panthers Sport Medicine, the official strength and conditioning center of the Storm, Dynamic Fitness, the official accommodation provider of the Storm, Rod Hotels and Resorts, and our nonprofit fundraising sponsor, Arsenal Best Cameron and Ellis Chartered Accountants. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the court your Storm Chasers dance team. Ladies and gentlemen, your Storm Chasers dance team. Ladies and gentlemen, the Storm have been honoring basketball teams here on Prince Edward Island. It's been quite a year for basketball teams. And one of the teams that has done Prince Edward Island proud is the Prince Edward Island Team PEI Canada Games wheelchair basketball team. Last week at the Canada Games in Prince George, British Columbia, The Team PEI wheelchair team went into the tournament ranked last. They were ranked number 9. They beat higher seeds, moved their way into the medal round, and finished the Canada Games as the 4th ranked team in the tournament. We have 3 members of that Team PEI wheelchair basketball team with us here tonight. And they include brothers Jeremy and Joel Watts, as well as Sarah Gillis. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a big hand to these members of the Team PEI Canada Games wheelchair basketball team. Ladies and gentlemen, never before has the Team PEI wheelchair basketball team made it into the medal round at a Canada Games. They are one of the many teams that have made Prince Edward Island proud this year for basketball. Ladies and gentlemen, Tim Hortons invites you to get into the dark with the new Dark Roast Coffee. 100% Arabica beans roasted with care for rich flavor and smooth finish. Come on, get into the dark.
All right, Eastlink Center, it's contest time here at halftime. We have a VIP family pass to give away to the Jack Frost Children's Festival that is coming up this weekend, all right? So we're going to play musical basketballs right now. We got DJ D Main Event, who's going to fire up some tunes. First, let's introduce our contestants. When I say your name, I want you to wave at the crowd because they're going to cheer really loud for you, okay? First, Avery Nicholson. We have Davis Nicholson. Oh, yeah. Megan Down. Oh, yeah. Nicholas Whitlock. Oh, look, a little more interested than that. And Jack Fleming. All right, so you guys are going to walk around these basketballs, and when the music stops, you have to grab one. But there's only 4 basketballs there. If you don't get one, you're going to be out, and you'll go and wait on the sidelines there, okay? Let's hear it from you guys, Eastlink Center, first. Oh, thank you, thank you. D-Main Event, let's hear the music. All right. Never know when the music's gonna stop. Their eyes on the basketballs. Oh, that one just got away from you. All right, you go stand over there by Rob. All right, and then there were 4. Hit it, D-Main Event. Feel free to clap along, fans in the stands. Ooh, all right. So now we're down to 3. Let's get rid of one of those balls. D-Main Event, let's hear it. Is the anticipation like really killing anybody else here? It's got me. Ooh. We got fake outs going on now, too. This is loose. All right, we're down to 2. 1 ball in the middle. This could get greasy. All right, let's hear it, Dave. Oh, head to head. A lot of determination in those eyes right now. Ooh! Oh! Yeah. That got interesting really quick. Well, here's, hold the phone, here's the good news. We actually have 5 sets of VIP passes to the Jack Frost Children's Winterfest. So you guys all win. Eastlake Center, let's hear it.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the court your Storm Chasers dance team.
About this bass. You really think I could be replaced? Nah, I come from outer space and I'm a classy girl. I'ma hold it up. You full of something, but it ain't love. And what we got is straight overdue. Go find somebody new.
You can buy me diamond earrings and
ladies and gentlemen, your Storm Chasers dance team. Ladies and gentlemen, down in the bar area, check that great looking truck. It's a 2015 GMC Sierra Crew Cab. It's an all-terrain package, fully loaded. It's a 4x4, 5.3 liter V8 with active fuel management. It's from Hillside Chevrolet, Prince Edward Island's Rough Country Suspension Lift Specialists. All right. Check us out online at hillsidechevrolet.com or stop by and see one of their sales guys. They include Bobby McGuigan, David Falls, Brendan McCloskey, Pierce McLean, Rob McDougall, and Brian Yonker. Come on in and see this 2015 GMC Sierra Crew Cab with the all-terrain package fully loaded at Hillside Chevrolet.
I was a baller. I wish I was a baller. I wish I had a girl who looked good, I would call her. Wish I had a rabbit in a hat with a bat and a 6'4" baller. Yeah, I wish I was a little bit taller. I wish I was a baller. I wish I had a girl who looked good, I would call her. Wish I had a rabbit in a hat with a bat and a 6'4" baller. Yeah, I wish I was a little bit taller. I wish I was a baller. I wish I had a girl who looked good, I would call her. Wish I had a rabbit in a hat with a bat and a 6'4" baller. Yeah, I wish I was a little bit taller. I wish I was a baller. I wish I had a girl who looked good, I would call her. Wish I had a rabbit in a hat with a bat and a 6'4" baller.
Ladies and gentlemen, we want to congratulate our Storm Social Media Contest winners here tonight. Winning family packs were Melissa Ross and Nicole Curran. Winning luxury boxes, Matthew Gillespie and John McIntyre. Hope they're enjoying the luxury boxes here tonight. And winning our Sherwood BMR Best Seats in the House, Judy Watts. You enjoying them down there? All right, they look like they're pretty comfortable. Follow us on Twitter. Join us on Facebook. You too could be a winner. Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget, playoff tickets are on sale at the Eastlink Center box office. And as a special thank you to our season ticket holders, and to provide great support to our team, we'd like to offer all current season ticket holders with bowl seats the opportunity to upgrade to the floor for the 2015 playoffs. We're offering Row B seating at the same price as bowl seating for the 2015 playoffs to our current season ticket holders. And note that Row B seats do not include access to the VIP pregame reception catered by Red Shore. Playoff tickets now on sale at the Eastlink Center box office.
I was too-
Welcome back here to Charlottetown, Prince Edward Island, the Island Storm. Halifax Rainmen playing in what is very well the most important game of the season for both of these clubs. The Storm and Rainmen playing for first place in the Atlantic Division. Here is Birdsong. He goes right to the hole. That's a miss. He gets his own rebound. And he is fouled. So two shots coming up. So a good start for the Storm. They needed that.
That'll be his third. That'll be the team's first.
So now at the line for the Storm, Lewis Birdsong will step up. And Birdsong at the line, an exceptional free throw shooter, 85%. Gets his first to go. The Island Storm have never led in this ball game. It has been all Halifax, and they were down 26 to Halifax at one point in the third. One of those reasons why would be the rebounds. Halifax up in that category. They're also up in the free throw attempts. They're also up in field goal percentage. They have dominated the Storm in the first half, but right now, somehow, the Storm are only down by 12 points. Endo gets right to the hole, but he misses. McMorrow, that was poked away by Williams. Now Zaglinski has it. He thought about potentially taking a three, a little Euro step, kicks it out now to Birdsong. And Birdsong triple teamed at one point, he stepped out of bounds. As far as scoring leaders go, no one really dominated. We have no scorers in double digits at this point yet, but a lot of great team play with both of these units. Haywood step back. That one rolls around and in. Back to a 14-point lead for Halifax. So for the Storm, it has to be how you open quarters and how you close quarters. Set the tone properly. You're at home. This is your building. You have to defend it. And that should have been Coach Salerno's message at this point. Coach Salerno, after the last defeat, said he was embarrassed by the way his team has played. So I could only imagine he would be feeling the exact same way right now. Mike Williams underneath. Foul and one. They needed that. Back to 12 points now, could be 11. The Storm haven't been within single digits since midway through the first quarter. Here's the replay of it. Williams, such body control, gets over the 7'2" McMorrow on that play. So this is also very interesting to note. Nico Corey, who has three fouls, is on the bench to start the half. The lead-in scorer, with the exception of Brandon Robinson, who is out of town right now attending his great-grandfather's funeral. He will be gone for a few more days. Here's Young. A turnover. Famutini gets inside that passing lane. He's trying to get it to someone. He's trapped. Finds Zaglinski. He gets it across the timeline now. And Williams is calling for it. He wants to go at McMorrow. He's going to kick it to Famutini instead, who finds in traffic Mike Williams, who is feeling it right now. It's a 9-point game, and the Storm are still attacking. What a play from Rashad Wack. Throws it right off Endo, and this Storm bench is fired up. Eastling Center is on its feet, and Halifax, for the first time in this ball game, finally looks like they are the ones who are in jeopardy. See the replay here. Williams all over McMorrow. He put his derriere right into McMorrow, and I gotta love that, because he doesn't have the height on that matchup, so he just uses his strength, and that's exactly what he did there. Turnover by Famutini. 3-on-1 for Halifax. Haywood goes in. A foul on Famutini. They're gonna call intentional foul. And these are the calls that I don't really like. I don't like the play necessarily, but it's always tough to make that call. I know they always do it in the situation when it's basically hit. You hit someone over their shoulders. But now for Jeff Smith, that's the third time he's been booed very hard by these fans here at Eastlink. Very interesting call. And it could very well be the correct call. I didn't see it from his angle either. Haywood misses his technical free throw. Right now, Smith is getting an earful from Famutini over on the sidelines. Haywood hits his second. Here's Klingscales, hands it off to Watson. Screen set, and now Klingscales inside, a lot of traffic on that. He somehow gets that one to go. I don't even know how he saw the hoop. Back to a 12-point game. The Storm, we're down by 26 in this one. Now down by 12, make it 10. McMorrow spinning in traffic. He is a big body to handle for the Storm. Also on the bench right now is Nick Evans. He has four personal fouls. So the Storm have to go with Mike Williams, who is 6'8", to guard Liam McMorrow, 7'2". At the foul line, McMorrow, a measly 53%. He hits that one, though. We'll see if he can get a second. Odds say that he won, so we'll see if he does or not. And he hits both of them. Zaglinski right inside again. That foul you could hear from up in the booth right now. That was a hard slap to Zaglinski's wrist. And Zaglinski looking at the official, he was saying, hey, that's a shooting foul. The official said, no, that wasn't. Trying to pull the wool over their eyes. You gotta love the effort by Zaglinski, but no dice that time. Whack, spinning shooting, a little bit short for him. Weak side rebound, and now Williams, 16-foot shot, sticks it. Klingscales in traffic. They're going to say a block and foul. And once again, this Storm faithful cannot believe the call. Really interesting call once again, because Mike Williams said he was standing still. And he was definitely outside of the circle. So now for Williams, that's his third foul. All of these Storm big men are in foul trouble. The only one we haven't seen yet is Cordell Jonte, who very well could be seeing action in this game. Actually, right now, he's lacing up his sneakers. Klingscales from DePaul University, 185 pounds. At the free throw line, not as consistent as you would like for a guard. Only shoots 60%. And he gets one of two there. So here's Zaglinski. And whack, double teamed. A lot of ball movement, something we didn't see as much in the first half. The Storm really playing a more motioned offense, and it pays off that possession. Mike Williams has lit it up here in the third quarter. Right now, Williams has 13 points in this one. A 9-point game once again. Here's Young up top for three. Too strong. And Williams pokes that one away. Zaglinski in traffic to whack. He steps out of bounds. Have to keep an eye on those puppies when you're on the court. You have to know exactly where your feet are. Sometimes you get so caught up in the motions you just take a few inches too far with your stop. You try to stop, of course, ideally, because the corner three is the closest to the basket. For those who might not know, it's actually a little bit closer than anywhere else on the perimeter. So that's why players often go there, but there's not very much room. There's only about 2 feet between the three-point line and the out-of-bounds line. There's Watson and Martin getting tied up in the backcourt. Foul goes against Watson. And that should be Halifax's fifth foul. So going forward, it will be bonus now for the Storm. Zaglinski inside, right to the basket. And Zaglinski was looking for the foul call, but at this point, you don't look for foul calls. They're going to say, count the basket. But if you're the Storm right now, you're the team who is trying to come back from a deficit. The best way to get the respect from the officials is not to argue with them. It's to play through it. The calls will go your way eventually. You are at home. You have been the top team in the NBL all season long, with the exception of the Windsor Express, but the top team here in the Atlantic. You will get the respect from these officials. It might not be on every possession, but you will get that. That one rolls out off of Williams, and it's going to be Rainmen basketball. Costly turnover for the Storm that time. That was right in the hands of Williams. Poked away. It looks like Daly might have got his mitts on that a little bit. And then it rolled off the foot of Williams. Haywood troubled to get it in. Watson just a few feet out from the hoop. Throws one up. Kevin Young put back, scores it. And now a delay of game warning has just been called on Watson. So Watson tried to chuck that ball into the third row to slow down this game a bit. And that will, of course, be a delay of game warning. Two of those would be a technical. Zaglinski pump fake. Little Rajon Rondo move inside. Another turnover for the Storm. That will be their 18th turnover. Somehow Halifax, though, was 17 right behind them. So both teams need to shore up the basketball a little bit more. Poked away. Haywood loses the handle. Zaglinski comes up court with it. Into the corner, Famucini. Bang! It's now an 8-point ball game, the closest the Storm have been since the first quarter. The crowd really into it now, chanting defense. Haywood sees a lane. Somehow, Daly got on that ball and threw it in. I don't even know if he was the one to put that one in. But Daly will get credited with 2 points. Whack goes inside. Young tracks down the rebound. Zaglinski fouls. Tries to stop the play. That was an intentional foul. Zaglinski only with one foul, but he looks to be limping right now. So we'll keep an eye on that. We know Zaglinski has had hamstring issues, but he really has a limp to him. Young gets that one around the center line. And get that weak garbage out of here, Rashad Wax says. My goodness. He just climbed up that set of stairs and took that one right out of the hands of Apaya. My goodness. Whack, only 6'3". Look at this. I guess we're going to miss that on the replay, but oh my goodness, what an absolutely domination block. That was a message right there. Mike Martin tracks down the rebound. Had a lot of traffic on it. Almost lost the ball. Zaglinski inside. They're going to say an offensive foul. Jeff Smith once again with the call that sends fans booing here at Eastlink Center. Coach Salerno is furious at Smith. So our foul is 13, And now we will have a timeout here from Eastlink Center. We'll be right back here in Charlottetown. All right, back here at Eastlink Center, Brett Poirier on the call, the Universal Media crew here with me. Lots of fun. I want to thank all of the Rainmen fans for tuning into this one, and of course all the Storm fans who couldn't be at the game. Young in the corner, 4-3, that one's short. It's a 10-point game right now. It was 8 points, but at one point it was a 26-point Halifax lead. That one way short, raises the rim, and the Storm clearly going all in. They have Nick Evans in this ballgame, who has 4 fouls. Nick O'Corey also in the game, too. He has 3 personal fouls. Defense! 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 Watson in traffic. Defense! Defense! And I don't know how that's not a foul call. There we go. Daly hugged Rashad Wack. Right now, Wack steps to the line for the Storm. He has done a good job in this game. 5 points offensively at the line. 3 of 3. Now 3 of 4. He has 3 turnovers. So he'll have to work on securing the basketball a little more. But right now, turnover is not really the issue for one individual player because the Storm as a unit have 19. Wack splits that there. And free throw shooting for the Storm. That has been their first miss at the line. They're now 10 of 11. So you can't fault that percentage. But they haven't gotten there very much. Back to a 9-point game. 69-60. Just under 5 minutes to play here in the third. An Atlantic Division title on the line. Young's layup no good. The putback by Daly also off. Famutini, he's hit a few threes in this one. He goes inside. And the baseline official saw a foul on that call. So a foul will be called there. Coach Pep Claros with Halifax can't believe it. So that will put Ulu Famutini's line. And I'll be honest, I didn't actually see that foul call. And the officials will say it is a shooting foul. Famutini hits his first. For Famutini, averages 5 points per game, only 18 minutes at the free throw line, 65% on the season. And he misses that, but tracks down his offensive rebound. And here's Okori now. Okori has been on the bench most of the third quarter, hands it off to Martin. A turnover that time. Chris Kale about to check in for Halifax. Both of these teams 19 and 12 on the season. So the winner will take that first seed, as I mentioned. Young drives baseline. He steps out of bounds. Somehow the Storm only down by 8 points. It was that 26-point deficit, as I mentioned, but Halifax has really turned off their jets that they head on in the second. They were all about that pressure defense. Turnover that time, Whack, furious with himself. Halifax running back with Young. Evans tried to draw a charge. Young goes around him and scores. Smart play by the power forward for Halifax. He saw Evans coming a mile away. Now Young and Evans getting tangled up a little bit right there. Okori goes in, he's fouled. And Young goes to the first row. He's sitting courtside right now with some fans. He'll get up right now as Okori will go to the line. I wish we had a camera shot on that. That was really funny. Kevin Young, there was two ladies sitting courtside and a seat open right next to them, and Young just falls right there and he stays for a few moments. Okori raises the rim with that free throw. His percentages have dropped. He was considered one of the better free throw shooters the league has actually ever seen. Came in around 90%, but for Okori, not the case anymore. He shoots around 83%. So struggling as of late at the line is Okori. Kale up top, Young thought about it, he goes in right hand, that's off the mark. Pep Claro's furious, charges onto the court, the officials don't make a call on that, and Mike Martin up top for three, bam! We're back to a 6 point game. The Storm showing signs of life here in the third quarter, and they are outscoring Halifax 24-16 here in the third frame. Kale spots up over Nick Evans. That silences the crowd here at Eastlink. Mike Martin goes inside. They're going to say a charge. That looked like the right call. Perfect position from Jermaine Daly. He was just waiting right there for Mike Martin. And now you can see the play. Yeah, great call by the officials. And Mike Martin has to do a better job of recognizing exactly where the defender is, where their feet are, and how steady they are. Martin, usually one of the smarter players in the Storm team, just got a little caught up on that play. Clink Scales goes inside, tried to lob it up, he does, for Daly. Still a 10-point advantage for Halifax. The Storm seem to be stuck around this number. McMorrow back into this game. So a tough matchup for Evans. Foul called right there on Famutini, he'll shoot two. Here's Famutini at the line. He's been playing so well this third quarter. Yeah. Talk about a chippy game. 42 fouls in this one so far between the two teams. Now Williams checks back into this one. Evans will come out. So you'd have to think that Salerno wants to be careful with Evans right now. Consider McMorrow is back on. Since Williams isn't in as much foul trouble as Nick Evans. He only has three. Evans with four. And a 3-second violation called that time. So another turnover for Halifax. Halifax not playing well in this third quarter at all. Mike Williams calling for it. Jumper. That one rolls in. If I'm the Storm, I am going to feed Mike Williams the ball every single time. He's shooting 7 of 8 from the field for 15 points. Fisher, little pump fake. He sticks it. Forrest Fisher silences this crowd. Fisher, his first point of the game. He's shooting 1 of 3 now. Okori hanging on to that rock. He sees a lane, goes right to the hole, he scores it. 47 seconds left. This Halifax Rainmen can go 2-for-1. I don't think they were aware of the time. Now the Storm can go 2-for-1. 39 seconds left. They'd be wise to hold it. Turnover. Click scales into Kale. He scores and a foul. And the fans, you can hear the fans shouting at the refs here in Charlottetown. I think that was a good call, though. Definitely some contact on Kale. He completes the three-point play. Now Rush checking into the game. We haven't seen much of him this quarter. And Famutini comes out to an applause. He played absolutely phenomenal for the Storm. They didn't expect offense from him in the capacity that he gave it to them, and he did a great job stepping this team up. He's got 11 points, 3 of 4 shooting. He's getting it done at the line. 6 second game clock, shot clock differential. Here's Okori right inside. And more foul shots coming up. And one thing I don't like about this game, unfortunately, it's become too much about the officiating here. Both of these coaches, Coach Salerno, Coach Claros, have been shouting at the officials all night. And of course it is okay, it's professional sport. And the players here on both sides have been shouting at these officials, but it's really not the way a game of basketball should be played. The officiating should be the last thing that actually matters. I will say the officiating, though, at some points has been a little questionable. There have been some calls that I don't necessarily agree with on either side. Now with 3 seconds left, Clink Scales throws that one up. And a foul called against Rashad Wack, and that's a call that I definitely don't agree with. I don't see the foul at all there. But Jeff Smith sees one somewhere. More boos coming Jeff Smith's way here at Eastlink Center. Rashad Wack walks right to the bench. He is furious. See, oh my goodness, that is not a foul at all. And we just saw the first replay. We'll try and get it up one more time here. Let's slip. Oh, I don't know about that call at all. No contact with the arms, and oh, that's a questionable call right there for Jeff Smith. Like I said, the officiating, something I really wish I didn't have to talk about as much in this game, but it's been on and off here tonight. And that will do the third quarter. Halifax up 82-73. We'll be back here in the fourth.
So after three quarters of play, the Halifax Rainmen 82, your Highland Storm 73.
Welcome back to the court, your Storm Chasers dance team.
Control and let it go for you till you gon' hit the floor. And rock to the beat till the morning. Walk in the club, it's fire. Kick somebody by the waist and
your Storm Chasers dance team, ladies and gentlemen. After the first half in Halifax at the AUS quarterfinal in women's play. UPEI 37, UNB 15. All right, time for the fourth quarter, and the fourth quarter is brought to you by the Conley Group. Now, the Conley Group was born from the belief that insurance is not about you, it's about those that you care for. For your employees, the Conley Group provides leading-edge benefits to protect them while they contribute to your company so they can be comfortable knowing that they and their families are covered by a medical situation or if a medical situation should arise. Find out more from the Conley Group here in Charlottetown.
Back here for the fourth and final quarter at Eastlink Center, Brett Poirier on the call. Make sure you connect with me on Twitter at Brett Poe or at BrettNBA. 82-73, the Storm are down by 9. They were down by 26 at one point. They've never led in this ballgame. Clink Scales, that one rolls around. Second chance, no good for Halifax. Williams gets the rebound. Jarosh into this game, has it now. And Williams across the timeline. That ball right into the hands of Rush, but rejected at the rim. Now Fisher, 4-3. He's a marksman. He sticks it. 12-point lead for Halifax. 4-3. Fisher, one of the better three-point shooters in this league. That's why he was brought to this Halifax team. DeRoche is trapped, steps out of bounds. Halifax ball. So right now on the court for the Storm, Zaglinski, Williams, DeRoche, Birdsong, and Rush. Here's Fisher, just drilled one, not that time. Kale, offensive rebound. He traveled. And on the court for Halifax, Forrest Fisher, Chris Kale, Jermaine Daly out there along with Clifford Klinksales and Nigel Spikes. Zaglinski fouled and the Storm want goaltend. And right now the officials are coming together. They might discuss if that should be a goaltend or not. But we're going to see the replay right now. If the ball was traveling down, it should be a goaltending call. Oh, and we can't see at that angle. The officials coming together. And I really don't understand what there would be discussed. It's something that you see. It's a goaltending call. It happens in that very moment. It's pretty clear if it's on the way down or not. The officials aren't going to be able to relive the moment by discussing it at center court. I don't understand why there's a discussion. And now Pep Claros is saying, why are you talking? Coach Salerno saying, make the call. and they're going to say goaltend. And Coach Pep Claros almost just took his sports blazer off. He doesn't agree with that call. And it's definitely a tough call. I mean, from our angle, it looked like it could have gone either way. It was up there, but it could have been traveling down. I probably would have to say that it was traveling down just because of the fact that Spikes was able to get up there so easily, because that was a high floater. The only way he was able to knock that down is if it was on the way down, I would say. Zaglinski completes the three-point play. A nine-point game now. Zaglinski all over Klingscales. He gets ticketed with a foul. That will be his third. Zaglinski's put a nice little game together. He's got 8 points, six assists, three rebounds. He had a triple-double not too long ago. He can do that. And what a lot of people don't give him credit for is his rebounding. He can get to spots on the court that a lot of players just can't do. Deep three from Klingscales. Oh, way downtown. The Storm will have no chance if Halifax can hit those for the rest of the game. DeRosh takes it right inside. And that was rejected by Spikes. Up top. Wide open. Spikes scores it. And we have another timeout called. Halifax up 88-76 here. We'll be right back from Charlottetown.
To make our draw for the Sherwood Mortgage Brokers, we're paying somebody's, we're going to be paying somebody's mortgage payment, monthly payment next month, up to $1,000. Hope you all filled out a ballot. The winner tonight of their mortgage, next month's mortgage payment up to $1,000 from Sherwood Mortgage Brokers, Emily Skierman. Come on out on the court.
Here in Charlottetown, Prince Edward Island, the Storm down by 14, 90-76. A bit of a run by Halifax. The Storm dominated the third quarter, 32-27, but right now Halifax up 8-3, scoring this quarter. Mike Williams says no, no, no. Williams has been so good for the Storm, 17 now, and he's only missed one shot this entire night. If I'm a Storm, I'm still going with the same model. Feed it to Mike Williams. Kale, Famutini on him. Kale spins, shoots. That's off, and an offensive rebound. Now a foul is called. And that will be called against Birdsong. And the officials right now trying to determine, yes, it will be on the floor, not a shooting foul.
Lewis Birdsong.
Yes, it will. A little miscommunication. One official thought it was a shooting foul. Spike says it's a shooting foul. But one official says it's going to be a foul on the baseline. So a foul on the floor inbounds for Halifax, but no foul shots. Clint Scales gets it inside to Fisher. Fisher with Okori on him. Okori has to play conservatively. He's still in a bit of foul trouble. But now that we're getting into the fourth, I guess he can play a little more aggressively, a little more wiggle room for him. Up top, not able to finish the alley-oop was Halifax and Storm basketball. I think Zaglinski got a little shocked. He was trying to help up Birdsong, but he was tied up with Daly, so Zaglinski was pulling the weight of two players off the court. Almost pulled Zaglinski down with him. 12-point ball game here. 9 minutes to go from Charlottetown. The handoff. Zaglinski, a little stutter step. Back to Williams. Zaglinski, nice fake inside. He scores. And now I'm not sure exactly what happened on this play. The officials blew the whistle just as the ball was inbounded. I'm not totally sure. We'll see the replay here. Zaglinski with a nice cut and the find by Famutini directly on the mark. All right, now a 10-point ball game. This Storm on a 4-0 run. Proud chance defense. In the corner, Fisher, that's an air ball. Here's Wack running. Wack has Kale on him. Kale about 6 inches taller than Wack. Here comes a three from Nick Okori. The bullseye. There we go. It's a 7-point ball game now. The Storm were down 6 in the third. We'll see if they can keep it rolling here. They need a stop. And a foul was called, an offensive foul against Spikes for an illegal screen. Now, Halifax once again looks to be in a little bit of jeopardy. They had a little bit of a slip up in the third. This amazing dagger by Okori. He had a hand in his face too. I don't know how he even saw the hoop on that one. That was much like a shot we saw from Halifax where there was absolutely no daylight, but they just threw it up and got it in.
Ladies and gentlemen, for you and your family, the Conley Group.
Right now, just off of the camera view, we see Nick Okori doing some work at the top of your screen. He's mopping up the floor. Look at this. Multi-purpose. Maybe there's a career for you, Nick, after the basketball. He's going around the entire court surface. Oh my goodness, Nick Okori does more than just shoot on this Storm team, that's for sure. He's a scorer, he's a defender, he's a playmaker, and he's also Mr. Clean. That might be the new nickname for Okori, Mr. Cleaner Upper. Williams drives, loses the handle, gets it back. Zaglinski for a three. That would have been huge. Would have made it a two-possession game. Clink Scales into Daly. No call that time. That actually could have been a foul right there. Looks like Daly might have got slapped by a few Storm players.
Back into the ball game.
So once again, the officials, who really haven't been whistle-shy all night, putting them away here in the second half. In the first, they took care of business with all of their foul calls, though. Here's Fisher now. Martin guards him. Martin's got the height advantage. Fisher steps back. And Halifax tracks down that long rebound. Joe Salerno saying, hey, the guys are hitting my guys off of the ball. The officials didn't make a call that time. Young in the corner now, 4-3, sticks it. Salerno is furious right now. Here's Mike Martin. He goes in and one. The Storm not going away. They are down by 8 once again. Mike Martin averages 15 points per game. Tonight, he only has 7. Hasn't been started in the last few games. It's been taken by Ulu Famutini. Also, Birdsong got the start here tonight. And at this moment right here, the Storm are down 93-86. How much would they appreciate the services of Brandon Robinson as Kevin Young goes up? He was fouled. And the fans not happy with that call, but that was a clear foul by Mike Martin. But now Pep Claros wants more. I think he's mad that that wasn't some kind of an intentional foul, I believe. We will see, but this game here really becoming chippy. My goodness. These coaches and these fans here are so into the game, and the players on the court, of course, are so emotional right now because this really indicates how far you will go in the playoffs if you perform well at home versus on the road, because the Storm play much better at home. Believe it or not, folks, they actually do play really well at home. They are in a slump, but for the Storm, they really want first. And now a foul called off of the ball. That will be the fourth foul on the Rainmen here in the quarter. Now Endo will check back into the game. And for Endo, 6 points, only 14 minutes here tonight, 3 rebounds, 1 assist. He has 4 fouls, so that has been keeping him away from the game. McMorrow also has 4 fouls along with Young. Young is in the game right now though. Nick Evans also on the bench with 4 fouls for the Storm. Whack on Endo. 6 seconds for the Storm on the shot clock. Mike Martin, 4-3, that one was almost down. And now Whack tagged with a foul. That will be the Storm's 4th foul here.
Storm foul number 22, Rashad Whack. That will be his second. Will be the team's 4th.
Only Whack's 2nd foul, so he can afford to be aggressive the rest of the way. Clink Scales, who's been getting the majority of minutes at the point guard position. Little hop step. That one up and in for Halifax. I think the officials right now are dealing with the problem. There's so much contact on every play as Okori sticks that one. It's hard to figure out which ones to actually call, which ones not to call. So I think they're just going to call the obvious ones. And Okori goes right to the ground. I don't know if that was a flop or not, but the officials didn't buy it at least. Young goes in, and they're going to call a foul on that one. Boos ring out here at East Link Center. Once again, I think the officials did get the right call on that one. Young looked like he was whacked a few times. So now Young taking free throws. Kevin Young, 6'8", out of Paris, California. He played at the University of Kansas with the likes of Thomas Robinson, Ben Malcolmore, Tyshawn Taylor, so some NBA players he has experience with. Really cool for him to have that experience under his belt. Okori loses the handle. Salerno wants a foul. And now the officials blow the whistle. I think a technical has just been called. A technical foul looks like on Coach Salerno. Or not. Now they're saying it's on Nick Okori. All right, so that technical will go against Nick Okori. Stormer down by 9 with 5 minutes left. This has been the chippiest grinded out basketball game we've seen in a long time here. Endo took that technical free throw, got it. Along with Fisher and Klinkscales, that's definitely Halifax's best shooting options. Zaglinski on Endo. Kale inside. Rolls around and out. Williams tracks down that rebound. I'd like to see the Storm give a touch to Williams on this play. He's only missed one attempt here. Give him another shot. Coach Salerno in the ear of Jess Smith once again. He's saying, why didn't you make that call? It was right in front of Smith, and now Smith is furious. He probably just gave Salerno some type of a warning on that play. That will be Halifax's fifth foul here. Zaglinski up top, 10 on the clock. Whack, 4-3, that's a tough shot. Off the mark. Screen set by Young. Endo has it up top. Now Young for three. That was almost down. The Storm catch a break. Zaglinski step back, long two. That looked a little bit rushed. And the Storm looked like they might be panicking a little bit. Just over 4 minutes to play, they're down by 10. The Atlantic Division title on the line. And Nick Evans still on the bench, which really puzzles me. There's Young, that's a miss. And Zaglinski crashes the glass. Famutini with Kale on him. Kale has got about 3 inches on Famutini. Famutini goes right into him. And another miss. The Storm are running out of time. Down by 10. 3:30 left here in the fourth. Endo into Young, and Young and one.
Basket counts for Kevin Young. Storm foul number 7 by Williams. It'll be his fifth. Storm over the limit. Lewis Birdsong is back to the ball game for the Storm.
What a find from Endo right to the hands of Young. And the Storm right now down by 12. 3 minutes and 30 seconds left. That's a miss by Young at the line. Storm have to hurry here. They're going to need a lot of good, clean looks and a lot of stops. Okori now step back. Sticks it.
Okori.
A 10-point ball game. We've seen comebacks like this before. The Storm have been stuck around this 10-point hump for the entire half. They'll have to break out of it right now. Endo, his three off the mark. And Famutini gets that one. Birdsong in traffic, missed the bucket. That was as good of a look as you're gonna get. Klinkscales, Halifax would be wise to start holding on to the ball right now. Up by 10, 2:30 left. And Halifax is holding on as long as possible. Young takes the deep three, sticks it.
Kevin Young.
That could have been the silencer for the Storm. 103-90 here. We'll take a timeout here from Charlottetown.
Miss Karen Brown. Presented with flowers by
so much hinges on this game, but unfortunately for the Storm, their hopes of securing that first seed in the Atlantic is going down. Kevin Young helping out the Storm. Puts that one in. They're going to give credit to Birdsong for the points, but that was clearly Young's hands on that one. Chris Kale inside. Easy bucket for Halifax. Giving it right back up. You cannot do that if you're the Storm at this point. Still a 13-point deficit. Pump fake Birdsong in traffic. Goes up using the right hand. Two Storm players still on the ground. And Halifax now up by 15 here. The officials just resyncing here. It's a miracle that Joe Salerno hasn't received a technical foul yet. He has been barking at these officials all night long. And for a good reason on a lot of these calls. Same with Pep Claros. There's been a lot of calls here, but really, the officials have done a great job of controlling this game, and you have to give them credit for that. This could have got physical a lot of times, but the officials have had a very tight whistle. Like I said, the fouls have been, I'm not going to say far and few between, because 31 called against the Storm and 26 called against Halifax here. Make that 27 on Halifax now. Corey to the cut in Birdsong, loses the handle. A jump ball was called there. A minute 20 left here. And now let's just take a quick look at how these playoffs will shape out. So if the Halifax Rainmen go on to win, which they very well likely will, they will be playing the Moncton Miracles in the first round. That means the Island Storm will match up against the St. John Millrats. And that obviously not what the Storm faithful wants here, because the Moncton Miracles have been a team that the Storm, for the most part this season, have had their way with. St. John, not as much the case. They lost to St. John about a week ago here at Eastlink Center. There's Nick O'Corey. And just a quick look at exactly why. Against Moncton, the Storm have been 6-2 this season. Against St. John, 5-3. So a little bit tighter of a series. But St. John has really bolstered their lineup within the past 2 months. They've made a lot of changes. They basically cleaned house. Endo for three. No good that time. 13-point ball game here. Here's Rush up top. That one hits front iron. But this game is all but over here. That's a foul against Wack on Endo. And I should thank all the fans in Halifax once again for joining the broadcast. I just saw a tweet right now from Jake Beckett, an NBL writer. So, yeah, there's your shout-out. Lots of, I really should have checked this earlier for people wanting shout-outs, but my goodness, the fans here in Charlottetown have not been treated very well the past 2 weeks. A five-game losing streak now by the Storm. And the Island faithful always sticks behind their team. The Storm will bounce back. That's what you have to remember if you're a Storm fan watching this broadcast. They're playing a team in Halifax that's just a little bit bigger than them. And it looks like their confidence might have taken a hit tonight. But the Storm will have a little time before the playoffs start. The first round should start in about a week. So they'll have some time to work on a lot of things. And they will have to work really hard. The St. John will not be an easy first round out. But now the Halifax Rainmen will become the Atlantic Division champions and play the Moncton Miracles in the first round of the NBL Canada playoffs. That should also be a good series, but Halifax has had their way with Moncton in the latter part of this season. That is going to do the regular season here from Charlottetown. It ends on a 5-game losing streak. We'll see if the playoffs are any different here. That is all for me in Charlottetown. I want to thank everyone for watching, our crew at Universal Media, and I will see you in the playoffs.
Center has playoff packages, playoff